Why do you need a witness? The whole point that we're trying to make is that in every trial that there has ever been in the Senate regarding impeachment, witnesses were called. The big problem I have, if we don't get to call meaningful witnesses, direct witnesses to the point, is that you're basically changing impeachment. Impeachment in the House is not the trial. You can have 3 days of lawyers talking to each other on both sides, 16 hours of questions, and basically bore everybody to death, talk everybody to death. But when you have a witness who was there, who was engaged in it, who was in the middle of it, telling you about what they were doing and why, it's a totally different case, and it's the difference between getting the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
For those of you who want to understand the American political system, on one end of the political spectrum is Lindsey Graham, and all the way on the other end is Lindsey Graham. This is a clip from the Republican senator in 1999 during the impeachment of then Democratic President Bill Clinton. And I'm not here to relitigate Bill Clinton's impeachment, but all I'll say is that there was an awful lot of sanctimony from Graham in a case where the president was being impeached for the grave cardinal sin of lying about oral sex, whereas the Republican from South Carolina seems much less interested when a president in his party, you know, embroiled himself in an international extortion scheme where he withheld hundreds of millions of dollars of taxpayer money as leverage to get dirt on his top political opponent as a way to interfere in the next election? Now, compare this statement by Graham in the 90s to his statement today when confronted with the possibility of calling new witnesses to testify. When asked if John Bolton should testify, Graham said, "No, I'm ready to go. If they want to call Bolton, they should have called Bolton in the House." Now, aside from the fact that Democrats did try to get Bolton to testify in the House, only to see him threaten to drag it out in the court system, the bigger point of contention here is that suddenly, Lindsey Graham doesn't seem too interested in the importance of witnesses who were, quote, engaged in it, in the middle of it, telling you about what they were doing and why. I guess that only counts when the subject is a Democrat. What's at issue here is that John Bolton has come forward with a statement, writing, "Since my testimony is once again at issue, I have had to resolve the serious competing issues as best I could based on careful consideration and study. I have concluded that if the Senate issues a subpoena for my testimony, I am prepared to testify." And what makes the former National Security Advisor especially attractive for investigators is that he was at the epicenter of Trump's Ukraine dealings and was a vocal opponent of Giuliani's involvement, which he'd referred to as a, quote, drug deal. His lawyers even announced that Bolton knows about, quote, many relevant meetings and conversations that House impeachment investigators have not been informed about. In other words, it should go without saying that if anyone in Congress was truly concerned with getting to the bottom of what really happened here, as opposed to just running cover for Trump, they wouldn't hesitate for even a second to call Bolton to testify. Now, I should mention too, that Bolton is no hero here. He knew the same information he knows now back when House investigators asked him to voluntarily appear to testify in their impeachment inquiry. But when he declined and vowed to take it to the courts, Democrats were left with little choice but to proceed without him in the interest of not carrying out the process for months. So whether he's only chiming in now because he thinks it'll look like a noble gesture and he knows the Republicans will never take him up on it, or if he's once again trying to gin up interest in himself because he's trying to sell his book, or sure, maybe he's had some moral intervention and wants to do his patriotic duty, all I'm saying is that we should all know better than to trust the GOP, and especially Trump administration officials, to ever do the right thing. And beyond that, yes, Bolton's testimony would be important, but it would only serve to reaffirm what we already know. We already have sworn testimony and evidence, some of which came from Trump himself, proving that Trump withheld millions of dollars of military assistance from Ukraine. We know that he asked Ukrainian President Zelensky for the favor of investigating the Bidens. We know that the aid was withheld only 91 minutes after his call with Zelensky. We know that American officials knew the aid was being used as a condition for official action. We know that Ukrainian officials knew the aid was being used as a condition for official action. We know that Giuliani was acting as a shadow State Department to facilitate the sham investigation into the Bidens. We know that Trump removed Ambassador Yovanovitch for the sole purpose that she was an impediment to the sham investigation. We know that Trump didn't actually care about the investigation being carried out, he just wanted the announcement of the investigation so he could use it in attack ads against Joe Biden. I mean, honestly, how much more information do we need to serve as proof that Donald Trump ordered and ran an international extortion scheme for the express purpose of getting dirt on his political opponent to help him in the next election? So Graham can continue to contradict his own statements about the importance of allowing relevant witnesses with relevant information to testify, but his objective is clear. Graham is only interested in running cover for Trump.
And it's the difference between getting the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.